I'm doing very well in my life romantically. I'm dating a grandmother. I'm dating a 39-year-old grandmother. I'm sleeping with a 39-year-old grandmother. Anyone else out there tapping that Nana? Anyone else? Tapping Nana out there? I highly recommend it. I highly recommend it. She's got kids. A lot of people start their own family. I got mine used. Pretty good deal. Bit of a fixer-upper. Great mileage. She's got it's a big family. Whole pack of kids. She's got 4 kids, 3 grandkids, 2 turtle doves. It's a full house. We've been interrupted during sex so many times that now I can't get off unless there's a knock on the door. So that's a kink I've discovered about myself. If we're alone, she'll wrap the headboard. Not the same thing. Need to know someone's trying to get in. It's just what it takes for me now. And I got to be careful. She is a 39-year-old grandma. She's fertile. I need to be careful. I need to be very careful because I love her, but she's absorbent. So, it's true. When I pull out, it's in the next room. Like, I can't take any chances. I can't. There could be a ricochet, you know. I don't feel like one of those McDonald's NBA commercials, like off the wall, off the lamp, off the poster, nothing but birth canal. Like, I can't. How the? Oh, man. Got to be facing the other way. She's, it's going great. It's going great with me and my grandma girlfriend. We've been together close to 3 years now. I've only accidentally called her mom 1 time, which is pretty good. Not ideal. I grant you that. Ideally, you wouldn't ever say that shit, but if you got to call your girlfriend mom, I'd cap it at the 1. My advice to you. I'll tell you the story. We're at this Italian restaurant. The lady's offering her the food that she ordered. She doesn't see it. She doesn't notice it. She's a grandma. She's got 8,000 things on her mind, 2 generations of kids to keep track of. She's zoned out. She's not focused. I want to call out to her. Normally, I just would have called her babe, right? That's what you call your girlfriend. You call her babe. But you have to feel babe before you can say babe. Aw, babe. You gotta be feeling the first. In order for babe to be the word that you say. I know that now, thankfully. I didn't know that then. Obviously, because at the time, I wasn't feeling aw. I was hungry, I was cranky, I hadn't eaten that day, I was hangry, I was impatient. So I was feeling ah, and that's not babe, that's come on, mom, which is not what you want to say at all. And she just stared at me like, what the hell did you just say? I'm like, yeah, she should dump me. That was the dumbest thing I've ever said. I'm single again. I go back on Tinder, find a younger grandma. I got up. I left. Eventually, I came back. I was very embarrassed, but I had to come back. She drove. She was my ride home. So I had to come back. That's how I was getting back home. I was in her car, one way or the other. And I apologize. I'm like, I'm sorry, honey. Can we just forget that whole stupid thing ever happened? And without missing a beat, she went, that's okay. I got you a slice of pizza, son. And we moved on like adults. She wiped the sauce off my face. That was nice. Didn't know that was there. Did me a solid with that. I'm just glad that mix-up didn't happen during sex. That would have been the worst, right? Oh, screeching halt. Screeching halt. Admittedly, it's more of an irrational fear than anything. Truth be told, I'm not much of a sexual talker. I have sex like a clerk in the Great Depression. Yep, I keep my head down, do the work I'm lucky to have. That's my philosophy. There's just so much unemployment in the world, you know? Be grateful for the gig, right? Punch in, punch out, no special skills, easily replaceable, let them know you care, work through lunch, can't go on strike, they'll be scabs. So, let them know. Let them know you appreciate it.